So these are the tobacco plants that we got from New Hope Seed Company earlier this year. This was around, I guess we got them, you pre-ordered them mostly, and we ended up getting these around May the 15th. And as you can see, there's actually 12 plants here in two separate paper containers. And this is the way they come when you get them in the mail. The ends of them are cut off. I'm not sure exactly why they cut the ends of the leaves off. But what we're doing here is we decided that we were going to grow these this year in containers. And so we're starting them off in these small containers. So we just went around and found 12 small potted plant containers that we had laying around. And we bought some soil and potting soil. And I think what we used was a Miracle-Gro, just kind of a generic potting soil. And this is essentially just after we got them in the mail and unboxing them, taking them out of the package and placing them in each container that they're going to go in and just getting them ready. This is our front porch, and we just chose this table to grow them on for the time being, mostly because we just wanted to be able to keep an eye on them. We want to be able to walk past them all the time, check them for bugs, make sure that they're watered, make sure they're looking good. The biggest reason why we've done that is because I've tried to grow them in the past, and you know, I'll go out in the garden and I'll plant these little plants in the garden, and although tobacco can be a hardy plant, when they're small and young like this, they really, to me, they need a lot of care and a lot of micromanagement. And I've had a lot of problems trying to grow them in the garden, trying to weed around them. The leaves can be very sensitive. They're almost kind of like a celery in some ways, in that they break, kind of the stems will break easy, the leaves will break easy. And of course, really what they're mostly related to are tomato plants. So this year we decided to kind of go in a heavy management kind of a method and plant them here on the front porch, and just try to keep an eye on them, keep them watered, and keep them fertilized. I used a Miracle-Gro tomato fertilizer, and I applied it once every 7 days. So say every Wednesday I would go out and I would put the Miracle-Gro tomato fertilizer on it. And because I read on the internet that since tobacco and tomato are so closely related, that they do the best using a fertilizer that's specifically here for tomatoes. And it worked extremely well for us. So here they are after they're all planted in our pots. And so this is what it looked like on our porch as we, you know, for the first few days. And like I said, I'd keep them watered if they ever dried out, but I'd only fertilize them once a week. And so this faces west, and what we found out is that tobacco, for some reason, it likes shade. These particular, I don't know if it's the Havana plants that are particular to this, but these particular plants do not like direct sunlight. They wilt very easily, they get under stress easy. So here we are after 20 days, and as you can see how well they're doing, how well they've done. And they grow extremely well, very, very good, you know, lush looking plants. The Miracle-Gro tomato fertilizer does really good for them. You can tell when you start to need the fertilizer because they'll start to get yellow. And in a second here, I've got four still shots where I show, you know, what it looks like when they need the fertilizer again, and then kind of each day afterward. So here it is, you can see when they start getting kind of this yellow green, and I added the fertilizer. This is like the next day, and they're starting to green up and they're starting to bloom out more. The leaves are, this is the next day, they're a deeper shade of green and they're getting bigger. And then this is like the day after that, and you can see how fast these things actually grow. So this is about day 40 since we got the plants. And see if I can get down the row here. I've got them outside. Well, they've always been outside, but I've got them in pots now, big pots. We've transplanted them about three times now. You see this pot, that's about a 5 gallon pot. And we transplanted them about once every 2 weeks since the time that we first put them out here. And you can see they're doing
pretty well. They like the shade. So you can see we got them under this tree, and if you put them out in the sun, they will wilt. If you notice this one here's a little wilty right now. It's got a lot of sun today, but if you were to keep them out for some reason in the sun all day long, they stay really wilty, like they're under a lot of stress. So we've learned that we kind of keep them on the edge of the garden here where there's shade most of the day. They get some early morning sun. This little one back here actually grew back from just a stump, I guess you could say. We had an accident, and that table that we had all the tobacco plants sitting on fell over, and that one got pretty much destroyed. So all of that growth has been within about the last 10 or 12 days from nothing more than a little twig sticking up out of the dirt. That's all that was left of it. This morning, I just came out, and you see these holes here. This is the first signs of tomato worms or tobacco worms that I found. And what I had to do was this morning go through and lift up every single leaf on every plant, and I found hornworms about a half an inch long, very young, just hatched out hornworms. You can see where they've gotten these in here really bad. And the only way to get rid of these things is to do like I'm doing here, turn it over, and usually along the edge of a hole is where they're feeding. They kind of go back and forth and just chew a hole. And so you can look along the edge of a hole, and you'll usually see if they're still small, if they hadn't gotten too big, the hornworms, and you just got to pick them off and kill them. And I've already gone through these this morning, every single leaf. And just now, though, I did notice a couple of really tiny ones that had just hatched out. You've got to get on these things as soon as you start seeing damage, because they can. I had tobacco plants one time a few years ago, and I didn't understand about hornworms, and I didn't keep a great eye on them. But I came out, and literally I had a plant like this that looked beautiful, no holes or anything. And 2 days later, when I came out and checked on it again, it was nothing but, there was no leaves. It was just stems. They had completely eaten the stems, and there was humongous hornworms on them literally after a couple of days. So you got to keep on them, and I'll do another film, let these go on a little more in these containers. We're going to keep them in these and keep growing up to about these 5 gallon and see how big they'll get. Thank you.